All right, so since last time I've finished converting all the types, the simulation types, to use structure types, structure type enums. So that includes the component pool base here, the loader, same thing, the resource pool, which I did on stream, and systems. They're all using this. And of course, that means like in the registrars and that, I've removed the dynamic cast entirely. They're all using like git component pools, using, you know, the simulation state and this, the struct type enum for all four sets. Resource pool, resource loader, git system, getting systems and component pools. So at this point, all that's basically left is to actually remove the requirement for the base type itself entirely. Now, a lot of what I was doing was based off the idea, you know, each, let's say, material pool would have like a reference count, or each, what is it, loader would have a ref count, init count, and the graphics init, whatever, and a p next, you know, and that would be the basis of this. But now that I'm thinking about it, like, is this really required? And of course I have, oh man, I got to get rid of these functions as well. That's not great. But I can work with this. I can work with this still. So, back to this. Struct type. What if I didn't actually need to have this information be a part of this? Because this, all of this information, other than maybe pnext, that may be moved over. I'm not sure. I'm not using it yet. Because if I was to just remove pnext from all these, it would have no effect. Because they're not used. But the S type and these things are all being used entirely within the simulation system, right? They're all used inside the registrars. They're all used, like, when I'm doing a registrar for something like that. Registrar. That's for, like, retrieving it from the simulation. That's for retrieving it for, like, operations, whether it's deinitialization or initialization or graphics initialization. And then, of course, I would also, at the same time, increment and decrement init count. But again, this is all within the, you know, the realm of what simulation is doing. So I think I don't actually need to have this information be a part of these types. These types can actually just should just be able to be run standalone like that. And then the idea would be that instead, in the simulation type, simulation state, where I have these vectors saying, you know, like I already have for the loader data, but the same thing for like pool-based data, component pools, and system-based, I would have structs like this one, which would have like, well, not this, but a void star pointer to the whatever it is. Maybe some things for functions like this, that so that I can move these to this side. And then have the S type, the ref count, the init count, the graphics init count, all be a part of this kind of struct sitting entirely within simulation state. And then when I'm adding or initializing that items, I'd have I would then run like I wouldn't have to do it for getting, but when I'm inserting, init, yeah, okay, I'm not entirely sure what I'm supposed to do with init count then. Init and deinit, that may, I may have to change that up a little bit. I'm thinking, I may add, so when I'm doing this, rather than interacting with the simulation state directly, I'd have like a, you know, simulation add component pool, which of course I pass in, let's say the p pool, so p simulation state p pool, and then I pass in what type it is, like that. This would all basically do the same thing as this. It would, well, it wouldn't actually create a new, but it would search for the same entry. If it's found, then it would increment the ref count and place it on the back. Otherwise, it would just do the ref count. So I could just kind of like really shrink all of this down into that. Same thing for destroyer, I think. It just basically run this kind of function. Not entirely sure about this. Destruction. I'm not entirely sure on how to do that because I don't know if I nude it, malloc'd it, calloc'd it. Or new or cat malloc is really the two things. Calloc just zeros it. Deinitialization. I'd have to have like a function that like initialize and deinitialize, maybe. If I just pass the pointer out, perhaps? Because I don't... Okay. This I can probably do... I can also then, like, return the ref count. Equals that. Or pointer, perhaps? No, I already have the pointer. I'd return the ref count. Like, how many times has this been referenced already? Perhaps... Okay, I already have one that I can actually work with, though. I have the loader. The loader already has some stuff sitting in here. So what I can do, void star... Maintenance function, okay. Do I have, where is this done? Here, p maintenance function, is that okay? I already do a reinterpret cast. Same thing here. Right, everything is still based off that. So maybe. Okay, right. So I'd have to move more of these over here. I mean, when I'm using this already, right? Keyloader. When I'm going through, let's say, the image loader, perhaps. Unload resource. When I do this, I'm calling like pLoader, can it process the create info? And then if so, I call the load function on it. These can be shifted over. Okay. These should be shifted over. So, first of all, we're going to have a bool function. pCanProcess. that, which takes in, let's just say a void star. Returns whether a given resource create info type, which is currently based off of that is still using dynamic cast for the create info. That's another one I got to deal with. Cool, but not yet. Function to be called to load a with a compatible resource type. Function. This, and then I need another function type, which is a post load. It's a bit of a, yeah, not great. So, p loader. Where's resource loaders called, right? Okay, it's only a number of locations I can work with this. That. Okay. Let's start at where I'm, okay, adding these things here. Wait a second. Yeah, no, this'll work. And process create info function equals do. Okay, right now it's still going to have to take that type in because that's just what it does, like that. I will convert it in the near future, but until then, I just want to get this function shifted over first. I'm not going to do anything else fancier quite yet. Okay, so image loader. Oh, this is going to be a bit more fun than I was hoping for. Can process create function. Okay. This could be static, right? Can this be like, can I do a static virtual function? Static member function of a class cannot be virtual. Ah! You're killing me! Okay, bool vote. Okay, this is quickly growing into not great. So let me just close up all this, let me close up all this, and just save it. So I got that, then I have the image loader on this side. Okay, then I need up here, before even that, I need this function, which does that. Which does specifically what I'm looking for is, where are you? Unload. Can there, I'm looking for this. And then you. Where is it? Okay, can I just do that then? I can. Okay. So that's one thing. And then I got the other one, which is the p load function equals. This is also going to have to be a static function. Which is like this. Pull image loader, load resource. So I got the P resource, and then I need the void star of P loader. Like that. So I do need an extra. A declaration for this, which is in the simulation. That all equals that. And then that means what we're going to do inside of here. Means we're going to delegate through. Technically, I could have also done this here as well. Return this, except it's not that, it's can process. Can I revert that, please? I don't have it. Mm-hmm. pick that. So that, and then this. Okay, yeah, that looks like that'll work. That's going to be, and I'm going to start changing these over, I guess. Material. Yo. Go down to this side and we do the same thing. Not in there though. It has to be public like that. Initialize graphics maintenance. There we go. Info p post load function. Okay, that doesn't look quite right. You're right. It shouldn't be there. It should be on this. Get out of here. Belongs there. Make sure that if this is okay, then I'm going to do the same thing for the rest of the loaders on stream, but not on video, because that'll be super boring. It'll be a repeat of several things. Yeah, okay, so here we go. Let's start with the rest. Actually, now that I just realized, if I'm doing this in one go, then what I can actually do to make things a bit faster is scrap that. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to rip them right out of here. These are just going away right now. That means they no longer do that, which means they're going to have errors, which means I can now, if that's the case, then I can start doing this, where I could just say, hey, this is a static function. I mean, I still need to pass in the type pLoader, like that, but I can work with that. And then worry about like renaming and getting stuff out of here and making free functions later. Any other resources? Probably down here somewhere. Actually, are there any of these resources? I don't think these are resources. Okay. So next we go down here. We have, of course, this is... Yeah. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay. These are gone. Oh, did I remove them from up here? There's got to be a better way to do this. Okay, how's about I have this is the front one, and then I have one which is like the internal, right? Like that, which doesn't have that. It's just the same one. I just put a smaller one in front of it for the moment. Then I can do this. That, right? I think so. That means I can just revert this stuff. Minimal change. That looks better. That, then we put in a new function in front of it. Or I could just do this, right? Yeah, that'll be a bit easier. What? Okay, whatever. Oh, and this, hold on. Collision shape loader? Right, I didn't, the armature loader, right. Right now, it's just, I mean, it's not pretty. It certainly isn't very pretty. If IT, okay, and then we've got to change this up. IT dot can process info. T can process info. Okay, that. And then it becomes P load function with the P loader here. Like that. Okay. Now I've got to do it in the other locations. Is always the problem, I swear. Like every time I do something and then I realize there's a better way to do it and come back through over and over again. Slowly refining the process, it takes time. Pecan process function. What we've got going on down here. We have this and this, okay. Right. I need to fix up the registrar. Okay, those ones, then we gotta do around here. These two. Up here we got the for the armature. Or did I just, I already did this one somewhat, right? Almost. Let's see what's going to break off of that. Seemingly nothing. Let's see if there's any extra memory leaks. 113 allocations, 24, 24, then the rest of the usual. Okay. The resource loader base is just that and these now. So, okay, much easier to work with. Is there anything else down here with functions? Create info? No. Component pool base has the maintenance function. I got to deal with that. Resource functions, resource, and then that. Okay. Virtual implementation. Okay, no. No. Be a required part of the thus in the original implementation. As pure virtual. Inheritance is being removed. It's no longer as such, the functions as to the then be called from there instead. Using provided function pointers instead. Which also means I'll probably remove some requirement of stuff to be in the registrar as well. I think. Okay, yeah. Okay. That's one piece out of the way. Now, back to the thing I originally wanted to do, which was to move simulation core. Starting probably on resource pool, moving these things out of here so that there is basically no base class required anymore. It's all this metadata is internal to the simulation implementation, and that's kind of it. All right. Okay, so that was a little bit of a dead end. I've reset things, so we'll try it again. Back to simulation again, and what was I doing? Loader, right? Moving stuff from loader out of here to another location. So rather than moving this stuff into the actual types, so let's say from the armature loader, rather than moving these into this, which is a bit more error prone. Like, do I really need this in here? Like, do these downstream classes need to know this information? No, they don't. Not really. But I do need to know it to get these items from the simulation and to add them to the simulation. So what should actually happen is we'll add them to, yeah, the struct type here. Instead, because these are almost exclusively just used by the simulation state to get the ones that we're interested in, so we only need this information here realistically. So if I was to remove these from here, then I can go to the armature loader. Wait, this is a loader base? Yeah. And I could just remove this. Remove that. And then rolling down to the registrar. It won't be here anymore. But instead, actually, no, it'll require a little bit more out of simulation, won't it? No, struct. Yeah, here we are. Rather than that, it's just grabbing it from there. If loader is null pointer and s type equals s type, then return p loader. Yeah. And then in here, we'll have to do some changes. If I need to update this, if okay. Shrink that down, so it's just it's operating on it, the iterator instead. But that breaks this side, since I'm returning the entire just the pointer to the actual loader, not to the struct, the simulator struct. Okay, back up just a little bit. So this means I'm gonna have to jump into simulation, where I'm gonna have to start adding some more interesting items. Would I put it here? Would I put them here? That way this is, yeah. No, I'd be here. So I need simulation functions that increment, the retrieve, increment, decrement, the ref count, the init count, the init graphics count. So, to start with, this auto, do I return size T or what? No, auto, get reference count from file simulation state. I need the type, if I can find it. S type. And the size T, P ref count, to return the value in. And it returns a standard error code. Simple enough. That's 1, 2, 3, 4 increment ref count. Decrement ref count. The ref count will be optional on these two, so you can return it if you request it. If it's null pointer, I won't return anything. So, and then this will be copy pasted for init and graphics init counts. I'll put it down here on the struct one instead. Not the deinitialized graphics, just this one. Do I want to actually subdivide the to like per component pool, component loader, or components systems? No. What I can do is I can go through all of them, can't I? I think. Maybe. Yeah. I'll do that. As long as the S types are completely unique for everything that goes in the simulation. In the simulation system, which is all the onus is on the user, then we're fine. So what I can do is, if I'm, this is on the internal side, so I can go for auto const and iterator through, let's say, p simulation state resource loaders for the moment. If that, star p ref count. Yeah, and then we return success. We'll go through the other types and then eventually we'll return faux simulation error type not found. It's going to be required, that's going to be new. Include that. Okay, I need a new error code type. Here, simulation. Simulation not registered, simulation not initialized. Type not found or something. Okay, just type not found for now. Kind of have to do the same thing here. If pref count not equal null pointer, then we do that. It's not a const in this case. So we're modifying it, and that's not const either. And then we do the opposite here for decrementing. Okay, and we do the same thing for the other two types. Init, graphics init. Okay, and then we just return that. Minus, plus, I may be going a little bit too overboard with the functions here. They're all very similar, so we want to change it up a little bit. I'm not sure yet. I mean, this will work for now. Init count, get that can That's sorry, not that. That one can't be. Git graph. Yeah, git graphics init count. Yeah, that can be const. That's going to compile fine, right? Make. Okay, yes. I'll just put it down here for the moment. Right, next part. Right, adding new types into the system. So for this, yeah, okay, creating and destroying items. So on the destruction side, creation first. Oh, simulation create resource loader is the big one right now. And let's just kind of give it this. No, out of the way. This. Create info. So, if this is the case, then what's going to happen? First of all, we need to make sure the type doesn't exist yet. So I need to check if in here, these four, I need to go through and see if they all equals null pointer. So if create info s type equal null pointer or 2, 3, 4, then I need to return another error code. Just going to say, you know, type exists. Already created. Or not created, exists. I won't say it's created the exact same thing. I'm just going to say it already exists. Oh, no. Perhaps if I know the type, I can actually, let's be way more specific. Otherwise, if we'll do that. Oh, simulation error type already created. If it's the exact same type. It'll return this, and if it's loader and versus pool, if it's created, if it's already available in the same type, like as a resource loader, it'll already say already created. Otherwise, it says already exists. Otherwise, at that point, then we can probably roll on down to. Or I just say already exists. Know. Just say it already exists. So if that's the case, then we have to do peep simulation state resource loaders dot in place spec. Make a copy of it, almost. Or is there anything else I want to do? Otherwise, return simulation success. Okay. And then we've got to deal with the destroying it. I gotta use the old-fashioned iterator because I want to be able to erase it. So I can't use the range. I need to actually use this. Okay, we're not looking for that, we're just looking to destroy this way. If we found the type, then we needed to do like just delete. No, I can't do that. I can't do that because it's a void pointer. I don't know how to delete it right now. It's very generic. So we'll do something like a delete. And then we have to do like resource loaders dot erase this. Okay. I found it. Otherwise, we've got to return oh, simulation type not found. Now, how do I delete? I don't want to return it. That sounds kind of awful. It's not like I'm releasing something. Although the user was responsible for creating it in the first place. I don't like the idea of having to return it and then having them delete it on their own. I mean, I could. What if? You know what? I will. Loader. Okay, I'm going to return it, and you can deal with whatever you need to do to destroy it, whether it's like immediately or delegated or whatever. The other option I could possibly do would be to like pass in a destruction, like a destroyer function, but I'm not really. I don't like that either. Because that would only be like taking in a void star, perhaps. And then you'd be limited. Be a little bit too limited to what you could do with it, I think. No, I'll return it and you can delete it the way you need to. Destroy, perhaps rather than destroy, it should be like release. I'm not actually destroying it, I'm just releasing it to you, back to you. Okay. Okay, I can work with this, I think. Back up to armature loader, registrar here. So, when I am destroying, okay, destroy? Okay, yeah, on destruction. Or on create. If no, it's just standard error code, and I need a size T for the count. So what do I do? I want to decrement if decrement ref count. For the armature loader, and I'm passing in count equals error count not found. Have a log. We'll have to do a log here in a moment. Else if, then if it's not that, then that means we return it. Then we need to check if count equals zero. Then I want to be the one to destroy it. So do this. If error code dot value else if count equals zero. resource loader p simulation state this, and we say, hey, it's and of that. Cannot from that to that, so it's void star. If error code, then we'll have to do something about the log. Else, we'll just have to delete p armature loader, right? Something like that. I'll have better logging. I'll have something to be able to return. And I don't need to know about the S type or the reference count at this point. And I don't need to do IT null pointer stuff. So, what's the local log type for resource? Okay, some logs there. Now on this creation side, let's try this. Let's try to increment. Do I not have error code? I do not. I don't mind if increment ref count. Yes, type, and then this could be null pointer. I don't really care what the value is. If that, then if not, then I need to add it. So then I need this. I need this, whoops, loader data, which is pLoader equals new. Dot. These three are the same. S type is that. That's the end of that. And then we have to actually add it. If there's an error here, we need to go to create failed. Otherwise, we just increment, right? Pose simulation increment ref count. That, and we don't care about it. And we need to say selected armature loader is true. Then I need to do delete selected, delete destroy. Okay, so I have a thing for deinitializing now as well, and initializing. So this, I need the error code. Count. So first of all is decrement. The init count. If error code, I need to like do a log. Otherwise, else if count equals zero, then I need to deinitialize it. That can't be const anymore. Okay, that's fine. Okay, you know what? Just that for the moment. Now I need to kind of do the same thing going the other way. So, I don't care about the selection right now. But if count equals one, then I need to get the loader, yeah. Then I need to initialize it. If there's an error code, as long as I increment it, I'm going to say loader is true. So at least I can go through and get it decremented down again. Okay. Okay, maybe. Now, I don't want to go through and do all of them before I can test this. So, moving back to this, I need to get this back alive. I need to do that. I need to do this. And I need to do this. But at least Armature is using the new system pattern. So I'm going to check that that works as I expect it to. And if it does, then I'll do all the others. Not in the video, but it'll be the same pattern repeated over and over and over again, so no point in recording that. No. The answer is a whole lot of no. So what is going on here? This is... fail to initialize due to physics error, missing collision shape loader. This may be due to the fact that this is still... this is entirely on the new system. So I need to do this if... otherwise... if... that equals that. For the old system. The old system still needs to exist for the moment. No. No. It's not happening. Failed. Okay. initializing simulation state. It's during the simulation state that I have an error somewhere. Do I destroy? Do I actually have anything for creating? Created simulation state. I should, somewhere. I creating created. Okay, so it is during initialization. So this is what, the physics one? Does this have an error? No, it does not. Wait, hold on. What was it? Simulation foe. Okay, hold on. I need to actually add these new simulation types first to the error code. Simulation error type not found. Okay, so somewhere inside of here, we have an error code. And that would definitely imply, to my mind, that it is somewhere inside of this one. On create? No, we did that successfully. We're on the on init. So here. Oh, no, that's the wrong one. Stop it. On another increment. So you have the S type, which is 4002. Which is this one, yeah. Okay. Did I just not put the thing in, or what? What's going on here? Oh, right. If there's an error code because it couldn't be found, then I need to add it. Not if it's fine. If they're incremented, then it's loaded. Oh yeah, okay, and this needs to be this way as well. It needs to be outside. Because if it failed here, then we wasn't added. If it's, it should be fine here. try it this way. This makes more sense, right? There we go. Let's error this. I need to really, like, I need to go back through and really get a consistent error messaging stuff somehow, somewhere. Let's make sure that I'm not leaking extra memory or something. 24, 24, then the rest. Okay. So, with all that, I just got to repeat that for all the other loaders. And then after that point, I'll have to do the same thing for the pools and the systems. I'll end the recording there for the moment until something more interesting happens. Otherwise, BRB. Okay, so that should be it. So I've removed all the loader no longer has these types. It's great. I got some new error codes for dealing with type. Type not found. Type already exists. That's great. Error code is up there. Great. Error code is here. Good. Struct has changes for dealing with resource loader because I'm no longer searching for the S type in the pointed to object. Instead, it's local, and because I'm managing it locally, I no longer need to check for null pointers. So that's good. Simulation, type defs. I got these. I got these new functions down here for increment, getting the ref count, incrementing ref counts, init counts, graphics init, and then creating and releasing. That's not really the right word to use, is it? I'm not creating the resource. I'm inserting resource. I'm adding the resource. Let's say resource. Acquire or release. Get, set. Set, add, am I adding it? Insert resource loader. Go with that. Is there a better way to do this? Probably. But I'm not going to do it right now. Simulation, setting these types, including checking for all the types. Back to, which one is this? Resource, so this is the armature. I've changed the destruction. It's a bit more involved since I'm checking the decrement. First of all, I check, make sure, is this something I'm even looking to destroy something? If it's something I'm even looking to destroy, check error code, get the reference count. If I couldn't get the count because it doesn't exist, warning message, clean run becomes false. If I did get it and the count is zero, that means I am the last one using it. I'm the last reference, so I will destroy it, delete it properly. Unless I can't get it for some reason, in which case I error out there. Return clean run. On creation, I try to increment it. If I can't increment, if I get an error code because I can't increment, that means it doesn't exist. So I add it. Or I insert. If I couldn't insert, I get an error. Otherwise, I insert it, then I increment it. Return true. That's the out case. Destroy selected armature loader, yes. Armature resources up here, yes. Okay. And a similar thing for deinitialization. And initialization. Okay. Armature loader, that's gone. That's gone. Physics, similar thing. Yeah. Yep. Same thing, same thing, same thing. Just removing all the constructors which I no longer require since I'm not doing inherited stuff anymore. And that just leaves the big one, registrar for graphics resources. I've replaced the macro with a templated function so I can actually step through it. Because you can't step through a macro without doing some fancy footwork or compile work. Similar thing, standard error code. If I can't get it, there's an error, return false. If there was an issue, return true. Let me go through. If I'm trying to destroy mesh, vertex descriptor, shader, material image loader, same thing over every time. Issues is an or if. So I've inverted the return value for this. So it start issues becomes false, and so I can do or equals each time. And return none, you know, if not issues. Yeah. Leave resources. Similar style going through with creation, although these are all done by hand. With way more error code checks or error output logging than before. Similar thing for deinitialization, a templated function instead. And the same thing for graphics initialization somewhere else down here. So this is still initialize. Yeah. Now initialize has to be hand done because each of the initialize inputs may be different, such as shader, material. Taking in shader and image pool, and then the other type using something from the init info. So that couldn't be done, but deinitialize graphics, same thing. It's templated type. Let me just double check this destroy up here. T star loader equals that, yeah. Deinitialize graphic item, The only difference here is that initializing graphics is always the same. It's always going to take in just the graphics session. Because any other types it's supposed to use or acquire, it already has. If count one, yeah. Return error code, because that can be used to go to initialization failed, to jump, otherwise we say the type is loaded. Okay. Another kind of, I gotta do something about this, but that'll be next time. I've spent enough time on this already. So. Removed. Members from loader base struct. Type reference initialization. Counts are loaded. Has been changed to with distanced. Nope, I'm no longer on that branch anymore. Bam, all done. So, last thing that I can do real quick is I should be able to just destroy this entirely. Like, just kill it. That should mean graphics resource, image loader is no longer part of this. And that's gone. That's gone. Okay, that should just leave some minor locations left. So this loader is gone. Okay. Be something somewhere in the simulation itself. Registration? No. In here. This was that. Okay. Void star, void star. Here we go. I need to find all those last locations and just convert them over. Quite. Do I even use this? Apparently I do. Cool. I didn't even realize. So do 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 do. So we go down here, we have, instead of that, we're using the new type, new function, to return what we want, which is getting... It's not here. No, it's under type defs, right? There we go. Get resource loader. Star that. And this becomes... P simulation set, comma, foe, graphics, resource structure type, material, collision, sorry, not graphics, collision shape, loader, loader. Which one is this? Shader loader. Okay. Make sure that works. Seemingly it does. Let's run it from the command line, see what kind of memory leaks we get, if any. 110 allocations, but is it 24? 24 usual stuff. Okay. Simulation loader types fully. Okay. Right, and I gotta do it via the command line. Finally, one part of my long-standing thing for making it full suite compatible is done. So I just got to do it for the rest. I've done loader, now I need to do resource pool, system, and component pool. which is going to be a little while as well. Plus a number of optimizations for sure. This is still kind of first draft of this new idea, system, pattern, whatever. So for now, that's it for tonight. Cheers.